Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or if this is your first time visiting my channel, welcome. I'm Christine. I love doing home and garden projects with you on here, as well as organizing, and of course, any requests you guys have, always feel free to leave them in the comments below, or reach out to me on Instagram, because if I'm not here, I'm there. I did take a little short break on social media during the month of January. The reason for that was not by choice. My vlogging camera actually died. Like, that was it. The last vlog you saw was the last one I shot on it, and I had to order a new camera. So hopefully that'll be coming in really soon. I am filming on my DSLR right now. It's a little, you know, larger and clunkier, so not a great vlogging camera, but it's great on the tripod. So today I was gonna be setting up my vanity mirror and kind of getting that situated, getting my makeup organized into the vanity, basically setting up my kind of rustic vanity space in my plant room. But then I was like, well, I don't know if that's something you guys actually want to see, so I'll just wait on that and I'll just make this its own video for now. So this is kind of like a bonus video today. So just a quick video to share the nail polish swatches from London Town Lacquer. And I mentioned these in a vlog recently. So I had gotten those in and I didn't swatch them for you guys yet. And a lot of you guys asked for swatches, so that's what we're gonna be doing today. So all the nail colors we're swatching today are actually a botanical formula, which I thought, oh, that fits in perfectly with our plant world in here. So they're a botanical based formula, so plant based. They're also vegan, cruelty free, the company, so they do not test on animals. And we're gonna be testing out these on us today. Oh, that's what I was gonna mention. So today, as I'm filming this right now, it is February 3rd and I have now completed 40 revolutions around the sun. So I just turned 40 today, which is crazy to me. And also, not only that, is today is my 10-year anniversary on YouTube, which is also super crazy. But I thought, oh, what better way would I want to spend my day than to get on here and film with you guys and celebrate my 10 years on YouTube with you. All right, so, okay, let's go and get to the swatches and I'll meet you guys back here afterwards. All right guys, let's get started with the London Town Lacquer swatches. So this one is uncovered and it's described as the perfect mix of beige, cream, and pink. And you guys, this is definitely one of my favorites, I can tell you already. It is absolutely a beautiful nude. I love this color. It applied beautifully, no streakiness. So this is just two swatches, no base coat, no top coat. It naturally is a glossy formula. All of the London Town Lacquer polishes are a glossy formula. All right, so I'm gonna come in a little bit closer. Don't mind my nails. Sorry about that, you guys. They're a little bit roughed up right now because I've had my hands in pumice and potting soil. I've been potting up a lot of plants and making soil lately. But I just want to show you how beautiful the color is. Absolutely love this one. This color is Plié, and Plié is a gorgeous, subtle fawn. It's a very feminine nude, and while it is very similar to the last one we swatched, Uncovered, this one is more fawn, the undertone of it, rather than the nude undertone of Uncovered. So they're similar in the same family, but different. And also the application was slightly different also. Uncovered is more opaque, and Plié is more, it's a little more sheer, but it still applies opaque in two coats. So right now I'm wearing two coats and no streaking. It was very easy to apply, absolutely beautiful, and I love that very feminine nude look. And the reason that they named this Plié is because the color is reminiscent of a classic ballet slipper. This next color is Pink Sands, and Pink Sands is described as a rosewood. It has more of a medium tone. So this is kind of a pink nude, but it has that bit of muted fawn color to it. This one is definitely a favorite. I really like this one a lot too, so Pink Sands. All right, let's go ahead and try out the next one. This next color is Plush, and Plush is a really unique color. They describe this as a mauve cream. And it is very creamy, it's opaque in two coats. I'm wearing two coats right now, no top coat, no base coat. It applied beautifully, you guys. This was so silky smooth to apply, absolutely no streaking. It is gorgeous. And the color is really unique. It's a lavender pink, or I don't know, it's kind of a lavender mauve with pink undertones. It's just a very unique color. When I looked at the bottle, I thought, oh, it's gonna be a cool tone, you know, kind of purpley shade. But then once you get it on, I think it's one of those colors that can really shift and look very different depending on the skin tone that it's on. And this somehow is one of those colors that I can picture this on anyone's skin tone, like from the fairest skin tones to tan and medium, deeper, richer skin tones. I think this would look gorgeous on everyone who's into those lavender feminine colors. And the next one, if my camera will stop looking at the leaf back there. Hold on. Okay, there we go. Okay, so this next one here is a classic beige nude. This is Honeymoon. This one is really pretty if you love those light nudes or grayish nudes. So this is definitely one of those kind of grayish beige nude tones. It's a little bit on the lighter side. So if you like those light nudes, this is definitely a beautiful option, but it's certainly a classic and I really like this color a lot. And again, I'm wearing two coats, no base coat, no top coat, and it's a flawless application, no streaking, really easy to apply, just a gorgeous, really opaque formula. And the next color we have here is Rosewater. Rosewater is described as a light pink cream. So I am wearing just two coats of this and you can see it's not totally opaque. So it does have that sheerness to it. And especially on this nail, you can see my nail line a little bit better than the other one. So I didn't get quite an even finish there. This one, although it is described as a light pink cream, I think that it has a little bit more cool tone to it. At least that's how it comes off on my skin tone. So it's not like a regular light pink or pastel pink. It definitely has a little bit more coolness to it. All right, guys, I just want to show you what rose water looks like with three thin coats. So I just applied three coats. So you can see how that looks, much more even finish. This next color is a sheer, and this is Waterloo Sunset. I've been wearing this color. It's been one of my go-tos for probably about 3 years now. I love it. It's a very pale, like super delicate pink. I do love a really clean, fresh nail polish like that. That's just really simple, not stark white, but just very soft and clean and almost like French manicure. But anyway, Waterloo Sunset, definitely one of my favorites. I'll do one more thin coat and then you guys can see what it looks like if you want to go a little more opaque with it. Okay, and this is Waterloo Sunset with three thin coats. So I just want to show you guys how that looks so you can get an idea of the difference with how opaque it is between two coats versus three coats. So either way, I love this color. It's just the most pale, delicate pink, and it gives your nails just a really pretty clean look. So if you love pastels or really pale pinks, this is definitely one I would recommend checking out. So this next color is Café au Lait, and this is described as a creamy taupe, the perfect ratio of milk to coffee, which I love that, and I love this color. This is one of London Town Lacquer's newest colors, at least one of their newest nudes, and I'm going to be showing you three nude colors, all in different depths. So this is one of the lighter ones, and it's still, even though it's one of the lighter ones, it's still more of a medium kind of nude. This color reminds me of like a khakis that you would wear on a safari, which I love the idea of that. So anyway, I love that color. Would definitely recommend if you're looking for a really beautiful nude, and I like the medium tone of this. It's not too pale. It does have a bit of depth to it and definitely would recommend. Love it. Oh, and this formula, super, super opaque. It was like opaque in one coat, but I'm wearing two coats and it is perfect. Really easy, flawless application. Our next one is a gorgeous nude. I love this one. This is Pecan Pie. This is definitely one of my favorites that I've tried out from London Town Lacquer's most recent launch of new colors. It's so beautiful. And well, you have to be into nudes to begin with, but medium nudes. And this one, it's described as a tawny milk chocolate with burnt orange undertones. I would say it's more like terracotta undertones, like a very dusky terracotta. And this formula applies flawlessly. It's super opaque in one coat. I'm wearing two coats though. But yeah, it's definitely one to check out if you are into those richer nudes or those richer earth tones. Absolutely beautiful. I love earth tones and especially anything with a little bit of terracotta to it. I love that little bit of warmth to it. All right, the next color we have here is Mudslide. And Mudslide is definitely one of those rich, deep, earthy nudes. It's gorgeous. If you love those chocolate browns, this one is described as a decadent deep chocolate brown. The formula is also fantastic. It's super opaque in just one coat. I did two coats though, you know how it is, just to smooth out your application. And it came out beautiful. And look at that, look how shiny that formula is too. Super shiny, no top coat there. The next one we have here is Chelsea Porcelain, and this is one of London Town Lacquer's two whites that they have. So Chelsea Porcelain is described as a milky off-white. So in comparison with their other white, which is Duchess, that one is a bright, stark white. It's more of a pure white. That's the one that I always wear. I've bought that one over and over again. This is my first time trying out their Chelsea Porcelain though, and it is definitely a softer white. I wouldn't say it's like a cream white or anything, but it's definitely like a milk, you know, a soft milk white, but not totally like off-white or anything. But it is a really pretty, easy formula to work with. The formula I noticed is a little bit thinner, so it does apply really easily. It spreads out over the nail very easily. I did get a little bit of a holiday on this nail here, so there's, you know, I got a little bit of unevenness going. But I only have two coats, so if you were to do three thin coats, that would be ideal and you get a beautiful, beautiful opaque application out of Chelsea Porcelain. Okay, here's the last swatch. This is Sugar Plum. They also have one called Sugar Cane, and I think that one is more of a goldy tone. This one is the cooler tone one, and it is a metallic, so it does have some silver sparkles in there. They describe it as a plummy rose gold, if I'm not mistaken. So it does have, well, I wouldn't really call it rose gold. There might be a little bit of rose gold, maybe flecks in there. But on your nails, it looks more like a plummy silver is kind of how, well, that's what it looks like on my skin tone anyway. So I know it can look different depending on the lighting and what skin tone it's up against. My skin tone is warm, so I don't think my skin tone is the best fit for this. So yeah, I probably wouldn't be reaching for this one, but I think overall it's a really pretty color for the right skin tone. So anyway, that is all for our swatches. All right guys, so those are all the swatches, and I'm very curious to hear if any of these colors stand out to you. Are they colors that you're attracted to? Like, what kind of colors are you gravitating towards lately? The colors I find that I'm attracted to as I've kind of matured over the years are more subdued. I'm really attracted to earth tones and the simplicity of white. And also, you know, those very soft pastels that are just very subtle and more subdued colors in general. Let me know in the comments below. I'd be very curious to hear also if you guys have found yourselves, you know, changing colors over the years. You know, like, what were you wearing 5 or 10 years ago? Are you still wearing the same colors, or do you find that you kind of gravitated in a different direction with your nail polish colors? I'd be very curious to hear from you guys also. Oh, and I should mention a few of the botanicals they use in their nail polish formula. So they use chamomile extract, which targets splitting, evening primrose oil, which soothes, cucumber extract is antifungal, garlic extract, which targets yellowing, rapeseed oil, which nourishes, and vitamins A and C for moisturizing. But also, they are nine-free. I think it's nine-free. Yeah, they don't use a lot of the main chemicals that are used in most nail polishes. So they are very gentle on your nails. And I've been using them for about, 3 or 4 years now. So anyway, yeah, they're definitely one of my top favorite go-to nail polish. And I've done nail swatches for London Town Lacquer before, so I think I still should have a working link. If I can find that, then I will put that in the description box below, and that way you can get a discount. I don't get anything for it. It's more like a traffic link and discount code for you guys. So anyway, I will have that in the description box below if you want to order anything on London Town Lacquer's website. And if you guys have any other video requests, always feel free to leave them in the comments below or let me know on Instagram, either way, and I will see you guys in the next video. Or probably I've got a post coming to you on Instagram, so I'll see you guys there. Bye.